it's already settled?
I think he announced the French foreign minister, the 30th.
Because they were talking about it.
They were talking, and maybe he called Mr. Shukri for that reason, that they announced the 30th of May as a fixed date for a gathering of 22 international participants without the two concerned parties, who will be invited in a later stage to the international conference. Take you back to the issues pertaining to our region. You cannot have a policy without Egypt consultation, without talking to our diplomacy on the best way to deal with the situation in Libya, in Syria, in Yemen. And of course, as you mentioned earlier, that Egypt was a hub to many important visits. It is to the concern and interest of the American administration, for example, to learn about the outcome of those important visits and the discussion that we had about issues that is of mutual concern, like the Libyan, the Syrian, the Yemeni issue, and as I mentioned, the core issue, the Palestinian. Israeli conflict.
Right. We move on again to the French visit, and we talk about the importance of Egypt now becoming a key market for military hardware for France. Egypt is the first country to buy French Rafale warplanes and also purchase two Mistral helicopter carrier ships and many other arms deals that followed during this visit. So if you can shed some light on this and how what does that signify for France on the other end?
Let me repeat the word I mentioned when I was carefully choosing it to describe the visit of the French president, that France is looking at Egypt with a view of a strategic lens.
Very important step.
Yeah, indeed.
Right.
You do not supply a country with its requirement from weapons unless this country is a partner, a strategic partner that deserves to be supported, being it politically, economically, or strategically, defense and security included. So, the French support to Egypt is within the framework of their understanding that Egypt as a stabilizing factor in the Middle East, Egypt as a forefront against terrorism, requires support from partners, being it, as I said, economic investment or military or security. Mm-hmm. Confronting terrorism, Dina, one has to be very clear. And the president repeated this several times. Confronting terrorism will not come through military and security measures only, though important, but through economic
that was plans. Also mentioned
of course in the press conference. It was mentioned. Economic and investment support to the Egyptian economy will facilitate opening up opportunities to the youngsters, to allow more future hopes to our people, and the youth are part of it. Second, ideological confrontation, cultural confrontation, as well as definitely the curbing on the finance and supply of weapons and personnel through illegal routes. And through the tacit support of some regional powers to this phenomena, terrorism, that is threatening Egypt, threatening the region, and threatening Europe. You have definitely followed what happened in Charles Hebdo and central Paris, and then last few weeks in the heart of Brussels and the airport of Brussels as well. Means that,
and even worse than here.
Even worse than here, but it is the same enemy, and it crosses Asia to North Africa to West and East Africa, the same groups, the same devilish ideology that is transboundary, well connected, well financed, and well supplied, that requires an international coalitions, regional cooperation. And supporting Egypt is in the core of this, because we are carrying the responsibility in defeating this evil forces.
Earlier, while you were trying to answer that question, you touched on a very important or in a similar way that like the way President Sisi spoke during the press conference that was held upon the arrival of the French president, when the usual topic of human rights was raised by international media inside, like usual, inside the press conference. President Sisi said that we live in a region that is very turbulent, and that the European standards of human rights should not better be applied in a country that is suffering from struggles and massive forces of terrorism financed by, like you said, international communities sometimes, or superpowers, or whatever, any entities, and political groups being recruited and all that. He suggested that the rights should be better included in developing education or better housing, which was a brilliant idea. So if you can like to elaborate on that.
I think the president eloquently answered this during the press conference, and I've heard it from him when he was in his talks in Berlin.
That is close very much to what you're saying.
Absolutely. And as I would like to approach this question with a clear answer, that human rights is very important. Freedom of speech is very important to Egypt, as it is to any European countries. And it is embodied in our constitution, and it was the most important aim and goals of our two revolutions. Having said that, I have to echo what the president has said, because it is truly the answer. We are in a turbulent region where the national state is threatened by non-state actors like Daesh or al-Nusra or
all the affiliated groups,
all the affiliated jihadist and Salafist groups that is not only threatening North Africa and Egypt, but also East Africa or West Africa, Boko Haram and Shabab. And other Al-Qaeda.
All the way down to South Sudan.
Absolutely. So those kind of groups threaten the national state that have kept the stability in our region. And Europe has came through a long process. I was ambassador to Germany, and we always tell Germans that we may differ in few issues, but let us settle on one very important factor, that stability of Egypt and stability of the Middle East of crucial importance to you and your stability. And we have witnessed the outcome of destruction of the national state in Syria and the impact Europe is paying through receiving waves and influx of refugees. So as the president also mentioned, that the right of life, the terrorism is a threat to life, the right of job,
terrorism
housing,
is a threat to human rights.
Absolutely.
The human rights they're talking
absolutely.
About.
Absolutely. There is no human rights to the Syrian refugee. He's thrown his child into water to escape and he dies. There is no human rights under economic hardships and pressures. What is required that Europe or anybody should understand, that the Middle East or Egypt is in a turmoil situation where the neighborhood is collapsing, and Egypt is almost the anchor of stability in a time where there is some forces from within and from outside is trying to divide the country, trying to destroy the institutions, to create an anarchy, to create an anarchy or chaos that will allow them achieve what they have maybe hopefully not achieved in Syria or in Libya or elsewhere. So I think gathering momentum, insisting that what we are adopting is a national quest, a patriotic national quest for a modern, stable Egypt that is equally respecting human rights like any other European countries. This is the ultimate goal, but one has to understand that we are enduring many activities that is truly threatening the national state and in face of waves of terrorism and interference from regional and international power, Egypt stands as the anchor of stability. And saying all this, Dina, back again to my early statement that human rights in Egypt and liberties are embodied in our constitution. We have moved into the institutional stage after the revolution stage, where we have now an elected president, a written constitution, and a freely elected parliament. These institutions can definitely take us to a higher level in all domain. But what is important to all of us is to protect the national state, is to protect our institution, is to move forward towards achieving all articles in the constitution. But mind you, we are in a very difficult neighborhood, and we are witnessing a lot of activities that is subversive and very threatening to our national security. Understanding this framework, talking about human rights, should be understood.
So let me recall a very important statement that you kindly echoed from the French president in the press conference, when he said that Paris chose to fully support Cairo in order to position both countries' relations towards long-term projects. That is also, that reflects significance. So the large presence of all those visiting 50 or 60 French businessmen, so does that prove how confident they are in considering Egypt's future, the coming 10 years or the coming decades, maybe more?
What has to be said to answer directly your question is yes. Look at the infrastructure projects that we have created over the past 2 years. The doubling of the Suez Canal, the nine tunnels under the Suez Canal, which is undertaken. Now, we saw the French president in an underground tunnel in the third phase of the third Egyptian underground done by a French company. Shows how huge, how impressive this project is. We are building a similar nine tunnels under the Suez Canal that will carry trains, carry cars, and will carry water. This is the veins of life between the valley and Sinai, and I think this is a very important project. And if I mention that, one has also to refer to a very important factor, that this infrastructure projects, coupled with the new discoveries of gas in the eastern and western Mediterranean, with the Egyptian existing already infrastructure, will I witnessed myself when I was ambassador to Germany just last September, the signing of an 8 billion euros agreement, 8 billion euros agreement with Siemens to add 17 thousand.
During the presidency's visit
exactly.
to Germany?
And the outcome will be 17,000 megawatt. Half of it will be added to the national power grid of Egypt 2016. It means that we will waive the problem from the normal citizen, but we will allow investors also the power required for running their houses and their projects. I meant by saying that Egypt truly is building up the infrastructure for the future. 4,000 kilometers out of 7,000 required has been accomplished. So if I referred, it's very important job. Maybe it's not seen as the tunnel visited by the president, but soon we will see it, we will use it, and it will add value to the attraction of our economy, which is, I think, in terms of investment, the second most important return for investment after Brazil. So Egypt is...